Welcome to my channel. Today I will explain to you the concept of dispatcher and performer. The manufacturer and the consumer. What is dispatcher and what is performer? What do we use dispatcher and performer for? Where are they both used? What are the advantages of this concept? I will explain the concept using a simple example. Are you ready? Let's start. Suppose there is a manufacturer. This manufacturer produces goods, such as juice. This manufacturer sells the juice to a supermarket. But it may also be, that manufacturer sells the juice to various supermarkets. The supermarket buys the juice from the manufacturer, and sells it back to the consumer. These are people, like you and me. Let's take a closer look at this example, how everything works in detail. We have the manufacturer here. He produces juice. In order to produce the juice, the manufacturer needs certain raw materials. So the manufacturer buys the raw materials, processes them and makes a juice out of them. After production, the juice is packed in packets, and then taken to the warehouse and stored there. The juice stays in the warehouse until a supermarket orders the juice. Once the order has been requested, the packs are transported to the supermarket. The packs arrive at the supermarket. These are unloaded and taken to the supermarket. After that, the prices are set on how much a pack should cost. The prices are printed on the pack. And at the end, the goods are sorted and displayed in the supermarket to sell them. After that, people come and buy this juice. This is the process from A to Z. I've been talking about manufacturers and the juice etc. all along, but what is the relation between this example and the concept of dispatcher and performer? Let's understand what the different parts of this process are called in the dispatcher-performer concept. I will list the individual parts first. Then I will explain each part, what this means in the dispatcher-performer concept. We first have the raw materials that will be used for production. Manufacturer who produces the juice. Juices packs. Warehouse where the packs are stored. Supermarket or the supermarkets that buy the juice from the manufacturer and sell it to the people. The people who buy the juice. I will now take the individual parts and compare them to the dispatcher and performer, what each part is called. The raw materials are the input data, which the dispatcher takes and gives to the performer to process. The manufacturer is the dispatcher, who creates the queue items. The packs are the queue items. The warehouse is the queue, where the queue items are stored. The supermarket is the performer, that processes the queue items. As already mentioned, there may be more than one supermarket. This means, there may be multiple performer processes. And the people are the SMEs, who wait and get the outcome of the process. But people can also be the result, that comes from the process as an output. This process is made up of two sub-processes. The dispatcher process. Input to this process is the input data, and output is the queue items. And the performer process. The input for this process are the queue items, and the output is the result at the end, of what the process has processed. Let's take an example from the RPA field to understand the model better. We have a list of people and their email addresses in an Excel sheet. An email needs to be sent to each of them, with a personalized message based on a template. We can use the dispatcher and performer model in the following manner. The dispatcher reads rows from the input Excel file. Then it adds the data, such as name and email of each person in the sheet, to a queue. Each queue item will have both name and email from one sheet row. The performer retrieves an item from the same queue and does the necessary actions using that data, like replacing template values and sending an email. As you see, we have an Excel sheet as input data. Using this data, the dispatcher created the queue items. The performer used the queue items to send emails based on a template. We have the result that each person in the sheet received an email from the robot. In the dispatcher-performer model, there is the possibility to have more than one performer process. This means that we can run the same performer process on several machines. Each performer can use the queue items, which are created from the dispatcher process. We could also use more than queue. This means the dispatcher can create the queue items in more than one queue. The performer process can then get the items from the different queues. Or we can also use more than one performer process. Each process get the queue items from one queue of the different queues. These are the first advantages of this model, because we can run the processes across several machines. Using dispatcher performer model, we can better handle the errors and have a good retry mechanism. We have also better separation between the architecture and the process layers, and also better separation of the actions, which are in dispatcher or performer. This model gives an improved orchestrator integration. And the last and most important advantage is that we can easily adapt these processes into a ReFramework if the processes are without ReFramework created. What is ReFramework in UiPath? How to create it and what are the advantages of a ReFramework? It's a big topic, which I will explain in a separate video. But in this video I will talk about implementing of dispatcher and performer processes in a ReFramework. How can we do it? Before that, let me remind you, what are the main parts in a ReFramework? ReFramework consists of four states. These are: initialization, get transaction data, process transaction, and end process. Let me first remind you also in general, what should we do in each state of these four? In the initialization state we can do the preparations, such as reading config file, launching the applications we need in the process, reading the assets from the orchestrator, or also connecting with a database. In the next state we can get the items from the queue, which we want to process. In the process transaction state, we can do the main part of the process, what the robot should do, like creating a report, sending emails, collecting of information from systems, etc. And in the last state, end process, we can close the applications, which we used in the process, or sending a report, or deleting temp files, etc. This is a general explanation of each state in a ReFramework. We want to implement two processes, dispatcher and performer. How should we do it? First, we have to create a ReFramework for each process. This means, we have two ReFrameworks. One for dispatcher and one for performer. Let's begin with the dispatcher. We have here the four states. Let's take the same example of sending emails to people. How can we implement this example here? As mentioned, in the first state we can do the preparations. In our example, we can read the Excel sheet, which contains the names and email addresses. The next state is, get transaction data. In this example, we don't need this state, because we don't have any queue items yet. It's a dispatcher process, which should create the queue items. Therefore we can delete this state. But in some scenarios we could need this state. For example, if you use the dispatcher to create queue items using other queue items. The next state is, process transaction. Here we can add the items into queue. We don't have any other steps to do here. But this is only an example, where we don't have many steps to do before creating the queue items. Normally we should do some calculations or read the data from different applications, to create the queue items. As already mentioned, it's only an example to understand how to create a dispatcher process using ReFramework. And in the last state, end process, we can close the applications, which we used. In this example we only used Excel and Outlook. We can close Excel here, if we didn't do before. Normally we close Excel directly after reading the data from the sheet. We don't need to close Outlook. The dispatcher process is done. What happens if we run this process? The process will create queue items using the data from Excel sheet. That's it. Let's move to the next process, performer. We have here another ReFramework for this process. In the first state we can configure the settings, do the preparations. In our example, we can read the email template in this state, but we can do it also later in the process state. The next state is to get the items from the queue. Here we get all queue items from the queue, but not at once. We get the first queue item, then it will be processed. Then the next item and so on, until we go through all queue items. So in this state we pick up the item from the queue. As mentioned, each queue item contains the name and email address of one person. In the next state, process transaction, we use the template to send emails. Here we should first read the template, if we didn't do it in the preparation page. Then we can replace the name in the template with the name, which we got from the queue item. Then we can use send email activity, to send the email. We should send the email to the email address, which we also got from the queue item. In the last state, end process, we can close the applications, which we used. Here we didn't use any applications, only Outlook. There is no need to close it. That's it. We have a performer process using a ReFramework. We implemented both processes, dispatcher and performer. How can we schedule these processes in Orchestrator? Let's see. First, both processes should be published in Orchestrator. In Orchestrator we then have two packages, one package for each process. We make a process out of every package. This means, we create a dispatcher process, and a performer process. After creating the two processes in Orchestrator, we can schedule the processes. But how can this be done? If you haven't watched the Orchestrator video yet, now is the time to watch it, to learn more about triggers. I will make a little reminder here though. Triggers are for scheduling processes in Orchestrator to start automatically. There are two types of triggers, time triggers and queue triggers. Time trigger means that we want a process to run at a specific time, such as 10 a.m. Queue trigger means that we want to schedule a process based on a queue. This means that the process is only started when a new queue item has been loaded into the queue. That was a little reminder about the triggers. Now let's see how we can schedule the dispatcher and performer processes. The dispatcher in our example can only be scheduled using time trigger, because we don't have a queue here for the dispatcher to work on. This means we schedule the dispatcher at a specific time, for example, at 10 a.m. Now comes the performer. We can schedule it using two methods, either time trigger or queue trigger. I will discuss both options. Time trigger, here we can schedule the performer at 10.5 a.m. for example. In this case, the performer runs after the dispatcher. If the dispatcher also takes longer than 5 minutes, it's not a problem, because the performer then waits for the dispatcher to finish. In our example, however, the dispatcher should not take longer than 5 minutes. The second option is queue trigger. Here we can specify that the performer should only be started when a queue item has been loaded into the queue. In this case, the dispatcher runs first and starts creating the queue items. As soon as the first queue item has been created, the performer is given an instruction to start. Of course, the performer will not start until the dispatcher has finished running. This means the performer waits until the dispatcher is finished. So we have both processes scheduled in Orchestrator. That was all about dispatcher and performer processes. I hope you could better understand the model now. As mentioned, in this video I only explained the dispatcher-performer model, but the ReFramework is another topic that I will address in another video. If you want to learn more about RPA using simple examples, please subscribe to my channel. If you like my video, I look forward to a thumbs up. Have a nice day and stay safe.